Welcome to Loop TV. I'm your host, Gene Munster, along with Andrew Murphy. Today, I'm actually your mixed host. Stay tuned because our topic is mixed reality, Apple's ambitions there, and need to give a shout out to the great work at The Information, along with Alex Heath and Wayne Ma, the work that they just published today. We are riffing off of this report, which we're going to get into in a minute, about what Apple is working on related to mixed reality. And when we saw the report, it's just exciting because it harkens back to June quarter of 2017, when Tim Cook in Loop's world famously said that AR is one of those huge things that we're going to look back and marvel at. And I think we're kind of taking a step in that direction. Before we get into the details of the information report and what Apple's actually working on, I'm going to mix it over to you, Andrew. When you read the news, what's the big picture? If we were going to do a quick take here and then dive into the details, think about this as kind of two segments in one. What's the quick takeaway?
I think the quick take is that Apple thinks augmented reality may be real, may be the future of computing, and they're making a bet here. The second piece of it that I think is worth noting is that Apple is going to add another device to our lives, expanding this multi-device computing ecosystem that only they can deliver.
Okay, that was about as laser focused of a quick take as I could ever imagine. Just to go back to that first point you said, is that there may be something there around augmented reality. If you're going to take the camp that there is something there, what is there? Like, what is kind of the big hope, the vision around augmented reality?
I think the vision would be that we can compute, we can use our devices without looking at a screen, and that a heads-up display would allow us to interact with information without being constrained to the limitations of a screen. So it's really the future of computing in a whole new way.
Love it. We're going to end the quick takeaway segment there and dive into some of the details. Before we do that, this information report talked about mixed reality. Let's take a step back. And Andrew, I'd love for you to define mixed reality, virtual reality, augmented reality. How do you make sense of this?
Yeah, a lot of reality. Augmented reality, we'll start there, is a technology that superimposes a digital image onto the user's view of the real world using see-through glasses that might look just like these. On the other side of the spectrum, virtual reality is more of a fully immersive simulation of a 3D environment in an enclosed headset like this Oculus Quest here. Mixed reality lies somewhere in the middle, where you're bringing the real world into a fully enclosed headset, akin to augmented reality, but using a virtual environment, where the cameras on the outside of the device bring the real world inside. So it simulates the real world in a way. And then it can augment with digital assets and information.
Well said, Professor Murphy. Sign me up. And let's talk more about the report from The Information here. That Apple is working on a $3,000, expected to be priced at $3,000 of this mixed reality, like you said. Kind of think of this as like ski goggles that you cannot see the real world, but there's 12 or so cameras on the outside that superimpose the real world to you. And they, I think, had an estimate that they could do $250,000 in the first year, which would be, what's the expected ship date, Andrew?
I think sometime next year.
Okay, so a couple years out, probably for now, 250,000 units. That compares to iPhone, which will do over 200 million units this year, just to give you some sense of context. Your take on the device and what really stuck out to you in just the details of what's being reported?
Well, the price tag will stick out to people, I think. And the idea there is that this is just the beginning. Apple's famous for entering a market with a very high-priced introductory product, like the phone and the watch, and then working a way down the cost curve over time. So the price point will stick out.
But let me frame in the price point is that it's $3,000. If you look at Quest, which is a great product, that is virtual reality. That Quest 2 ranges between $300 and $400. We're talking about almost a 10x price increase. So I hear you on Apple, they start high and then kind of work themselves into the mass market. But this feels like a standard deviation outside of high.
Yeah, on the high end of the mixed reality glasses landscape, there is the HoloLens, which sells for $3,500 today, okay, but for very niche use cases. And that would be the second big question I think people will debate is, what are the use cases here? Is this for gaming or is this for general computing, right? Is this more like a game console units volume or is this more like phone volume? And time will tell. And I think the use cases will drive that.
What's your take long-term? Is this more of something for gaming or something bigger?
I think it's somewhere in between, probably closer to gaming console than a phone, at least for the next 5 to 10 years. And similar to the Apple Watch that adds to this multi-device ecosystem. And we've been thinking about that ecosystem and how the software plays into it. More to come there.
Fantastic. I want to go back to kind of the overarching theme. The big takeaways here too is that, you know, we talk about this transition from reality to virtual reality, mixed and then augmented. This path will take decade plus to get there. It's likely Apple will have glasses probably 5 years from now. Facebook has said that their lenses, so they're one of the few that have actually given some sort of put a stake in the ground and said eventually they will have some sort of wearable glasses, AR glasses, to be out. It's expected in 5 years. I don't think they've given an actual date, but that's our anticipation. So we're still a few years away from that. And I would like to mention too is, you're kind of piecing all this together in this futuristic, and Andrew's holding up those goggles and thinking about, like, does the world need this? And why are we doing this? And I would just take some insight. It's hard to predict the future. It's easier to look back at the past and learn from that. And I think what we have learned is that there is this appetite and to try new digital experiences, whether it's television, high-res DVD, the internet, mobile, all these things that have had just this massive change. And there's a part of me which doesn't want this because I just like reality. But there's a part that says I'm old and the future is going to really embrace these. I'd like your take on this, Andrew. Is there really a market for AR longer term?
Well, I think the smartphone is the most revolutionary device I've ever seen in my lifetime and potentially in all of technology. But it also created problems. And we do all of our computing today on a screen. Imagine a world where you can do the same computing and more without the limitations and focus and distraction that a screen can create. So I think that the end game here is to free us from our screens, but not limit the amount of computing that we can do. So there is a vision where AR replaces the smartphone and unlocks people to be more human, more interactive, and less bound by the limitations of the screen.
Awesome, helpful outlook. We're going to end it there because that kind of puts us on a trajectory to keep you all updated on what Apple and the other players are doing. That on behalf of Andrew, Gene, and Loop TV, bye for now.